move on to the next part, that is how to get a white color background. So if you want a white color background, you have to have light coming from the background. Alright, so if you want to have a white color background, you have to have a softbox. There is no second opinion on it. You need to be having a softbox if you want a white color background. So let us see how I'm going to be achieving it. So right now I don't have studio lights on me, but I have this little boy, which is my speed light. So what I'm going to be using is, I'm going to be keeping this upwards because I'm all alone and I'm going to be managing this on my own. I don't have anybody to help me right now. So you can see I have opened the softbox and the white color surface has become my platform. Alright. Yeah, so I'm just opening it up like this. So if I want a white color background, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the prosthesis and I'm going to keep it inside my light like that. Alright, so let me remove this and show you all what I'm actually saying so that people have a clear understanding of what I'm saying. So since you want a white background, you cannot keep a white color wall. You are never going to get a white color background if you keep a white color cloth on the background or a white color paper in the background. You're never going to achieve it. So you have to have a light source behind the subject. All right, light source also should not be a continuous light source. It should be a flash. So what I'm going to be doing now is I'm going to be taking the picture of this premolar with a white background. The premolar is kept on this soft box. I'm sure you all can see now. So my flash is going to fire inside and my soft box is going to be the background for this shot. Alright, so let me go ahead and take a shot with this technique. Honestly, in my clinic I use Elinchrome FRX light, so it's much more easier. I've not done this for quite some time because I have the leisure of using Elinchrome in my clinic right now. So what I'm going to be doing is, since I'm going to be using the speed light, I am going to be firing with my trigger, right? But I have to climb on my bed because this is quite tall. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to keep my camera like this pointing at the premolar and I'm going to be taking the shot. But before that, I just want to see if they are in sync. Yeah, there is a blue light coming in, so it's definitely going to work. I don't know about how exposed it will be. If it is overexposed, what I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce the flash power. But right now the first shot is just going to be a trial shot. So let's go ahead and take a shot. Yeah, so that's what I'm getting. It pretty nice. Okay, so my picture is quite overexposed, if you all can appreciate. Actually you can see the tooth but not on Facebook. Yeah, you can see it now. So what I'm going to basically do now is I'm going to reduce the flash power. So I've got down. My flash power is on half right now. And I'm going to make it to 1/8 because my image was quite heavily overexposed. Alright. So I'm all set to take the picture now. Let us see. This is 1/8 power. And I have managed to get the shot. Let us see how the picture looks like. Alright, so this is the first shot that I got. Okay, it's not easy to see like this. Show like this, now it'll be better. This was the first shot that I achieved. So I have a clear white background, but the problem is it's overexposed. So what I did in my next shot was I reduced the intensity of my flash. So this is how I managed to achieve a white background. If you all can appreciate. But there is one small problem that has happened. how do I get rid of this texture on the cloth? You can appreciate there is my cloth texture over here. How do I remove it? Any suggestions? The answer is fairly simple. Alright, how do I remove the texture on it? So I'm going to repeat the shot, but this time I don't want those surface textures also to come. So what I'm going to do is, instead of keeping the prosthesis on the cloth, I'm going to hold it a little away from the cloth. Alright, so since it's going to be a little far from the white color cloth, the white color cloth will go in the blurred area, and I'm going to be hoping that the texture won't be seen. So what I'm basically saying is, don't keep it on the white cloth. If you can hold it in your hand and then take a shot, that will be really good. Right, so now I'm going to be holding this in my hand and I'm going to be taking the shot. So I have the premolar in my hand and I have taken the shot. Need one more shot. One more. One more. Yeah. So we'll see what all problems happened when I was taking it in my hand and shooting. Let us see if we can overcome the situation. So if you remember, this was the shot which was overexposed. Since it was overexposed, I had to reduce the flash power, and this was the shot that I got with the reduced flash power. It is fairly good, but I somehow got textures over here. Alright, in order to remove the texture, my choice was to remove the prosthesis from there and take it in my hand. So this was the shot which I got when I took the prosthesis in my hand. So what has happened in this case is, my background is white, not purely white, it's grayish white. So that's because my image went underexposed. So what I did was, I tried to change the direction because light was not coming on the distal surface of the tooth. It was coming on the surface which has the light pointing towards it. So I had to turn the face off towards the light surface so that the light comes on this surface also. But none of them have been fairly satisfactory. But my last shot was pretty good as compared to the other shots. But if you can appreciate, none of them have a pure white background as compared to this one. So this is the whitest background that I could manage with this light. So I think I'll be probably keeping it like this only, and make this fully white in post-processing. So this is the only technique that I can think of. I'm going to try it once again, but this time I'm going to be keeping it pretty close to the white cloth. So I'm back on top. Okay, so I'm going to be keeping this fairly close to the cloth now because I've learned my lesson, and I'm going to take the shot again. Yeah, so I have managed to get the shot with a full white background this time, and there are lesser textures or almost no textures this time. Yeah, so we have textures, but they are less as compared to the previous one. So I have to keep on playing with it. The other option is increase the flash power so that you don't get a grayish background. That is also a very good, increasing the exposure is going to be helpful. So the only option that I'm left with is, so I am on 1/8 power right now. So I'm on a very, very less power. I'm on 1/8 power. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make it at 1/1 is full flash power, so it's going to be very, very powerful. and I'm going to be having a very high chance of getting a white background now. So I tried all kinds of things to get a white background, but every time I was getting texture. Unfortunately, you cannot get this right if you have a cloth. Instead of a cloth, if you would have had a white cloth flexi-glass sheet like the ones that you have in the X-ray viewer, then it would have been helpful. But inside that, behind that X-ray viewer, you should not have a constant light source or a continuous light source. You have to have a flash, okay? It should not be a tube light or an LED light. So I'm going to be taking the same shot again. This time I'm going to be keeping it really close to me rather than the cloth. But I'm hoping that I'll get a white background because I've increased the flash 8 times. Alright. So all set. Oh, that was really very bright. And finally, I have managed to get a full white background. This help was given by Dr. Umesh Pai. He is live with us right now. So let us see the last picture. This is the last picture. If you can appreciate, it's a full white background. There are no textures whatsoever. Alright. However, if you keep a white cloth behind, you're going to end up getting pictures like these, the grey color pictures. Okay, please don't use a white cloth or a white paper behind it. Or if you want to still use it, what you can do is you can bounce the light on the paper so that even that becomes a purely white background. Even that is a good idea. I don't know how to explain it right now. I don't have a piece of paper with me or on me right now. I don't have an A4 sheet. But what I can do is I can remove it and show this to you. Okay, it got stuck. So what I'm saying is this. There is one more way of getting it right. It should be this. Yeah. So if you have a white color cloth, you can keep it on the wall like this, but it's never going to give you a white, pure white background. So if you want to make this pure white, you have to have a light source going on this so that it reflects a lot of light and you end up getting a bright background. Basically, there has to be a whole lot of illumination coming from the background if you want a pure white background. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be keeping my speed light pointing on the wall so that it illuminates the wall and then reflects the light back onto me. This is also one technique, but I'm not a very big fan of this technique. Another way you can get a pure white background is using a tent, which is like a box, it should have a flash and not a continuous light source. So please don't I have seen a lot of places where they are selling you a box kind of a thing. They assure you that it's going to give you great backgrounds, but it has continuous lights. Don't fall for prey. Don't go ahead with them because they are continuous light sources. However, you get a tent for flash as well. So if you can manage to get a tent like that, which can help you put flash in them or outside them, that is a good choice. But don't go for opaque tents. Alright, so we have finished. This is much more easy if you have two lights. So what I am saying is one light will be your background and one light will be your actual light source. Okay, so what I'm saying is, suppose this is the prosthesis, this is the background like this. So what is going to happen is, since the light is coming from behind the patient, this part of the prosthesis might become fully black. You have a white color background, but still that part of the prosthesis will be fully black, the part which is not getting the light. Okay, imagine this situation. So you are like this, that you have a white color background, but what is going to happen is there's no light coming in on this side. So what you can do is you can get this slightly on this side, So some amount of spillage will happen and you will get good illumination. But better is to put light from this direction also. So this is your background, and to illuminate this part of the prosthesis, you want one more light over here. So having two lights is always better to get white background as compared to other stuff. Whenever you have bland looking prosthesis, please use colored gloves. They give a good contrast and they help you to get wow looking pictures. For example, over here I have a light blue color glove. Pink color gloves also look amazing. So basically anything and everything that you shoot with studio light, it ends up looking great. Even if I would have had cowdung in my hand in this picture, it would look gorgeous. That is what a studio light is supposed to do, and that is what it actually does. And the last one is a white background with a reflection. This is also possible with a mirror. So suppose if this is the light source and for your white background, and this is your patient, and suppose this is where my little finger is, where my camera is. So what is going to happen is, I'm holding the patient like this for the time being. So if my camera is over here, I'm going to get a white background, yes, but there is no light falling over here, so this might turn out to be fully black. Okay, so ideally you should have one more light source over here. If not, what you can also do is you can turn this background slightly like this, such that you have white in the background also and some light is spilling over in front on this side also. You can do it with one light also, but this light has to be really big enough. This is a very small light for me to handle. You can manage it with one light also, but having two lights is always better. Yes, Masa, having two lights for a white background is way better, way more easy as compared to a black background. Do you want to see that happening? I can do it right now and show it to you. This is a very good question actually. I'd be more than happy to show you what I'm explaining. So I'll just turn the camera around for you all to see. So what I'm going to do now is, I'm going to be using my softbox again. What I'm going to do is, I'll put my speed light in this. Yeah, so I have my short box and my speed light is also ready. What I'm saying is, it's a little difficult to manage the situation if you have only one short box and only one light. Nili, this is for you. It's a very good question and a very important question to answer, because everybody should know about it. I'm putting my flash at half power tentatively. Okay, so what I am saying is, okay, so if this is my white background and this is my patient, right? This is my white background and this is my patient. If I shoot from this direction, there's no light coming in over here. So this part will be fully black. So let me do that and show it to you. So you'll be able to understand much better. So I am putting the trigger so that I can fire my speed light. I'm getting a blue light in my speed light, so it is going to fire for sure. There's no doubt about it. I'll be coming back to my 100mm macro lens. Right? So what I'm saying is, if you can appreciate, yeah. So what I'm saying is, if you keep your subject like this, there is no light which is going to be falling on this side, because I am shooting from this side. Okay, so I'm going to get a white background, but this side has going to be, is, I'm not going to get any light coming in on this side, so this will be fully black. Let me do it and show it to you so you'll understand. All right, so I need some space, so I'll just move you all slightly. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go ahead and take a shot and the background will be fully white. But I might be having issues on my side. Yeah, okay, so this was a black and white picture. it came in monochrome because my picture style was on monochrome. Let me get your colored picture. I'm going to put the picture style neutral again. Alright, so what I'm saying is, yeah, you can see what has happened. My background is white, but there's hardly any light coming in over here. Okay, let me show this to you on the tab. It'll be easy for you all to appreciate on the tab, I think. I'll show you the image over here. See how the picture is. There is less light coming on this side. So it's, the background is white, but very less light on this side. So what I'm going to do now is, I'd be really happy to get one more light source on this side. So what I can do is, I can get one more studio light. So this is another studio light that I have, and I can use it on slave mode. All right. And I'm going to be putting light over here. So yeah, I've reduced the power quite a bit because I'm very close to my subject. Yeah, and I'm going to be repeating the shot and showing it to all of you. Let me just check if it's firing or not. It is firing, both the lights are firing. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to repeat the same shot, but there'll be more amount of light on my side this time. Yeah, I need some more light. I'm going to increase the flash power slightly. Yeah, let us see the difference between both the pictures. So this was the first shot, or the initial shot, and with the second light, my picture is like this. I have more light as compared to the previous situation. So this was the previous situation. Very less light, and now I have slightly more light. I can increase the flash power and get in more light falling on this side as well. So I have increased the flash power on my side, I've increased the flash power of this light. So you can play around with this. It's a permutation and combination, nothing to worry about much. Yeah. I'll increase it even more. We have more and more light coming in on our side of the patient. So we have even more light that has come on our side of the patient. Right? This is a very good question. If you don't have two lights also, you can manage. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put this off. So this one was working on the slave mode. So as soon as the light falls on this, when that one fires, this also fires. So I'm going to be putting this off. And I can manage the situation with one light itself. What I'm going to do is, instead of this position, I'm going to change the position of this, and my patient is going to be like this. So if you can appreciate, the light is not only my background, but it's falling on my side also. It means the light is falling on the first and fourth quadrants also, because the light is coming in from here as well. So I'll show you the difference between both the directions. Let me keep it like this first. Now it's perpendicular to me, completely perpendicular to me. Let me take the shot and show it to you. So this is the wrong direction. Now let me get it in the right direction. You can manage the situation with this angle change also. So this is the second direction. I'll show you the difference on the tab so you can appreciate the difference better. So in this situation, light is completely in the background, right? But when I turn the direction of the light, now light is falling more on my side also. So just by turning the light direction also, you can manage the situation very well.